else we say women's forum want to embarrass me very seriously. Because if he, even if you point one for me, I cannot sing. But thank you. Madam Chairperson, the honorable ministers of government here present, honorable members of parliament, our development partners here present, the elegant, beautiful and shining ladies of the Sierra Leone Women's Forum, distinguished guests, members of the Fourth Estate and our social media representative, a very good evening to you all. And I bring you greetings from my dearest husband, retired Brigadier Julius Madeleine. I know we all know he's in Saudi Arabia representing us in making sure that Salam for better. I greet you in the name of Allah. I greet you all in the name of Allah, the magnificent and the merciful. In his name, I commit our evening to. It is an honor for me to be selected by the Sierra Leone Women's Forum to deliver the keynote address at this year's 5th annual prestigious award and fundraising dinner. The theme you have coined for this year's dinner, Making the Gender Equality and Women's Empowerment Act 2022 Work for a Better Sierra Leone, is not only timely, but fascinating. As a pragmatist and not a politician, I will take the view that we approach the theme with holistic and collective responsibility. In Sierra Leone today, we have made strides to emancipate and advance our women and girls in our national development. At least, our society can no longer permit any man to just go about abusing women and girls freely because they are afraid, as they say, na Fatima in picking them. The Hands of Our Girls campaign, the state of emergency declared on rape by His Excellency the President, the one-stop center created, and we now have a sexual offenses model court, the enactment of the Gender Equality and Women Empowerment Act of 2022 puts the icing on the cake. We are now an envy to majority of other countries around the world. While we are happy and shouting all over about the significant progress we have made in putting into law the issues that have been holding and preventing us from total participation, inclusion and expression in all aspects of development from the homes, schools, communities, the workplace and even in governance. I would hasten to say the most difficult and challenging part of our work starts now. Whether by nature or otherwise, we the women have our internal and social demons, and we must accept that. Our career pursuits often clash with customs, traditions, norms of raising a family, in no marriage, in no born picking. Most times when a woman is educated, they refer that to them, in no marriage, in no born picking. So they are not married and not born picking them. Cultural extension from access to resources. Na girl picking in no get, na woman and in no forget hand. Now the Gender Equality Act have made that very easy for us. You can own your own land now. You can actually have your name on your land. If you don't want to put your husband's name there, put your name there and make yourself secured. From participation in politics and in governance, woman not for being paramount chief, woman not for being councillor, or woman not for being parliamentarian. I believe the gender bill has settled that for us. Policies and law, discrimination in pay and other opportunities. The gender bill has addressed that also. On the social side, the naysayer will also say, women don't usually support each other. Women don't support each other. Is that true? Look at us, we're here supporting the Women's Forum. Women, when became educated and empowered, they look down and low upon their spouse and can even become uncontrollable. These are just the things to put us down or to scare women to actually take their rightful places. Feminists are aggressive and have a compromising stance. No, we are not aggressive. We just know what we want and we go for what we want. Sierra Leone Women's Forum and the women of Sierra Leone, do we want to make the skeptic have their way and day? This is my question to all of you women gathered here today and even those that are not here. Now that the GIWI Act 2022 is here, let us begin the arduous task of making it work for obvious reasons. Make Sierra Leone a better place. My suggestion as to how we can make GIWI Act 2022 work and make Sierra Leone include, let us know what the GIWI Act 2022 is. Read the text, understand it, and appreciate what it can do for you. You need to understand the Act, and then you will know the benefits that is there for you. Human rights defenders will tell you that in fighting for your rights, the first thing to do is to know those rights you have. You need to know your rights. After knowing what the GIWI Bill Act is, we can now join to publicize it and as well create the awareness of its existence and what it is about. Empowerment. Here I suggest a holistic empowerment in education, knowledge, access to resources, opportunities and services. To do that, we need to challenge ourselves and dare into the traditional comfort zone of men. Let us increase our numbers in professions like engineering, carpentry, mechanics, medicine, information and technology, aeronautics, etc. Organize ourselves into formidable units and very cohesive and strong force for this wind of change that is happening now. We should sense this. There is a wind of change happening in Sierra Leone, and it is the time for us women to take advantage of this and make sure we position ourselves at the front, so when the wind swings, we swing with it. Harness technology and innovation so we can be in the time of total and above all. The world today is about digitalization. We need to concentrate on that, and as women, we need to be empowered when it comes to digitalization. Let us support each other and not allow people to dictate what we do or what we don't do. Before I conclude my speech, let me remind you that in the first term of the new direction government under the leadership of my dearest husband, the flagship program of the medium-term national development plan 2022-2023 was human capital development with free quality education at the helm. This was deliberate and for obvious reasons, and we are all seeing the benefits. In this second mandate, the focus of the government is the Big Five Game Changers of the Sierra Leone People's Party Manifesto. Feed Sierra Leone, Human Capital Development, Youth Empowerment Scheme, Technology and Infrastructural Initiatives, Revamping the Public Service and Architecture. I am appealing to you all to align all your interventions with the Big Five Game Changer so that we can work together to make it happen for Sierra Leone. To conclude, let us just reflect a bit on what the GIWI Act 2022 and advancement of women have given us. In the current parliament and cabinet, Sierra Leone can now boast of at least 30% membership in all government institutions. In addition, internationally, we can now boast of the adoption of 2 UN resolutions, Access to Justice for Rape Victims, and the UN World Day, November 18, for the prevention and healing from victims of child sexual exploitation and violence. Let me use this platform to inform you all about the upcoming commemoration of the first anniversary of the UN World Day in Sierra Leone, which I championed last year and the United Nations voted for this. And I also want to take this opportunity. As I would want to also take this opportunity to inform you that for that celebration, the First Lady of Nigeria and the First Lady of Angola will be in Sierra Leone in solidarity with all our victims, and we will stand hand in hand with them. And we also have Sinash, who is coming also to lend his voice to the campaign Hands of Our Girls on that day, so that we prove to the rape victims that they are survivors and we are standing with them. And I also want to add on my speech here some of the achievements. Just September, the United Nations has also appointed me again. I know you know they appointed me a few months back as one of the 8 eminent people around the world to champion zero waste. And this time, the United Nations has appointed me to be the champion for adolescent girls under the UNAIDS. I am grateful to Sierra Leone. I am grateful to my dear husband for loving me and for showing me the way. Nation, we are all part of the Women's Forum, and I want to be grateful to the Women's Forum for acknowledging me as your First Lady of the Republic of Sierra Leone and for accepting me to be part of your process. And I can assure you, any day you call, I will be there. My door is open for you, I will support you, and I'm looking forward to February 24 to see what we will do together. Celebrate Women's Forum that year. Before I go, let me acknowledge my mother who is here, Aje Kaba, my mother and my dearest, dearest Mrs. Moibe. Every time I see you, you stand out like a rose, and I want to say you are fabulous. This is the woman who actually showed me how you can do things. The first vocational school which I am involved in this country. It was her that leads the way, and I want to say thank you for believing me, ma'am. At this juncture, please allow me to officially launch the Women's Forum land that we're here today to fundraise for, so that we build an office that befits the name of the Women's Forum. Thank you so much to everyone of you. May God bless you.
This is the land situated off Peninsula Road, York. It is 5 acres granted to Women's Forum Sierra Leone, Center of Excellence, by the government of Sierra Leone. It is of 2 parcels or segments that has been physically planned by the Minister of Lands, Housing and Water Supply, and has been accessed with a 30 meter road right around its corridor. The first parcel is 6.5 acres. Designated for the administrative buildings, guest houses for local and international partners, and multi-purpose hall. Second segment or castle is for the staff quarters. The 3.5 acres parcel is relatively flat and cost-effective, whereas the other 1.5 acres parcel is slightly slow in topography but also user friendly. The document has been drawn, submitted for processing. Counter-signature by the director of superintendents.
Would be to fund it. how to fund it, how to put the whole thing in money. Most of us, the next time we're going to get out with it. But meanwhile, we'll ask him, if they are happy, then he sat them while they having that lunch, the fundraising.
So start serving me, my team, and then we can move on with the rest of the guests.
Yes.
So why you focus on food, Patrick? I think same beginning with Monica. Let's go to fundraising. We always talk about supporting women. I think when I earlier said you have to be more deliberate in supporting women. So we've come to a point where we're kindly encouraging all of you, our lovely guests, to one way or the other be a part of the construction process for the space that Women's Forum has been able to secure. That structure is not going to plant itself. It's going to take resources. So you can give cash, you can offer for healing, one cash for 50 bags cement. You understand? Just nicely. So those of you who are nice enough, who are very deliberate about women's empowerment, we would like to see you put your hands up and pledge. So here's how it works. When you pledge, you don't necessarily obviously have to give what you're pledging tonight. They're just going to ask you three things: your name and institution, what you are pledging, and your contact details. So they will follow up with you at your convenience. So at your convenience. So we are with a big one of support. Nothing is too small and nothing is too much. So if now one bag cement you want me, if now all get back cement you want me, it's all welcome. So we will one pledge. Can we please see the hands? Sorry, I need three members of Women's Forum, please. I need one person at that end, one in the middle and one on the other end with a pen and a paper. Take down the details of those who will be pledging. They're very generous people over there. We're very deliberate about women's empowerment.
Take out money.
Yeah, and then to hypocrites. People that really need to support women's empowerment.
I don't mean you very generous. Other people are very generous.
Can we see the hands, please? Can we see the hands, please?
Honorable Paswari, a generous man.
And you can choose for make you pledge private as well. You go just issue one, we go send one of the members that spoke up to you. You can tell them in confidence, waiting for the pledge, and they will contact you at your convenience. So the people that were not hypocritical about women's empowerment, let's see your hands go up.
Hands up.
Let's see your hands go up. No, we can't eat. We're about to have dinner.
So, food will they take a bite table here? Will they take a food by table? When they reach that table, they can't call them the table. So, then they go to African dish, salon dish, and say, I'm going to smell that. Petetelite, I don't smell that. That's petetelite, if I don't be doing it. All of them will have said, Master Sam, or Mr. Ibrahim Ramaswari. Generous people and trust them. And people ask their generosity and philanthropism. It is beyond the clouds.
So you can do a pledge for yourself as an individual, or for your institution, or for your family. Just be deliberate tonight and support Women's Forum so that they will successfully able to construct the massive structure that they just not displayed to them. So they don't take one step, they don't get in hand. Now we go for it. Oh, God bless you.
And this might end up benefiting a relative of yours. So if you don't support now, you might take
a step. He's the first person about to pledge. But I'm not going to. You could say what you want to say. All I want to come from.
The first
person, Naman. Willing to make a yes, Naman. Thank you. We notice, Naman. Please come from. Willing for me, the first person to make a pledge.
And the center, I will recommend the Martial Arts Academy. Sports for all and martial arts for women. I am the president of the Secretary of Karate Federation and I am UNESCO instructor in martial arts. Okay, so I will give pledge secretly and we're going to continue. We're going to have sports for the particular AMA. So we're going to have Victor and Montana. Okay, good.
Senora.
Any other?
So that's our very first pledge for tonight. So you pledge him in private. You don't necessarily need to announce so we all with you pledge. It could be for you as an individual. You could pledge for your institution. You could pledge on behalf of your family. But please meet the events tonight and let's support the women's school. Come in there, able to put on the school. Nothing is too small. Okay, let's continue. So the rest of the week, imagine that
worship people and we serve for me very fast about that.
Hold on.
We come to our worship presentation.
And I want to be said before school and they're about to pledge. Hold on. This is breaking news.
On behalf of me and my family, I pledge 5 bags in it.
Wow. 5 bags in it.
Thank you very much. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you.
Five bags.
If you want to keep some success, yes, let's keep pledging. One box nail, let's keep pledging.
Yes.
So, the rest of we were there, we're not intentional about supporting Women's Forum. Are we not intentional about supporting Women's Forum?
Okay, you want one pledge? I see a people on this one. I think I'm going to start. Anybody want pledge? Some is everyone by the way, so they come down by the table. When they eat your table, they can come down, so. Tell my boys. Anytime, shortly, we go to the presentation of awards for people that have supported the work or activities of Women's Forum Sierra Leone. And 12 champion women's empowerment and gender equality.
So we still kindly ask for that for being nice enough and believe it to support Women's Forum reconstruction. The land baby. The land baby women. All they need is our support for able to put the materials together to make this start reconstruction. Even if I tell you to give 1 bag cement. Till we always know as we're not that intentional about supporting Women's Forum. I'm not. We don't know there with at least 1 bag cement and new Women's Forum.
That was an ambitious project presented. But Mrs. Olga Moibe wants to donate. A recognition pledge?
Donation. Me and the president of Women's Forum in
great.
Now
we two
don't want it.
Great.
That's going to be
yeah,
it.
We
want
pledges.
Who are
the
other people?
They
can't
for
the
artists.
Let me take this creation from there. That's going to be
it.
I know Mrs.
Moibe. Don't clap for it. At least if we don't pledge, you are the pledge. Don't send it away to me.
Yeah. And let me take this creation from there as well. That's going to be, you know. More hands, any water pledge, commitment, donations.
You don't necessarily need for now what you're pledging or donating.
I can't yes,
look at what you
My name is Amisha Kandantarawane. I represent Tampin International on behalf of Tampin. I'm a great man on the bank.
$100.
Yes, thank you very much.
$100 gone into Women's Forum's construction of an ultra modern structure at York. An ambitious project that will impact a good number of women and the activities of Women's Forum, advancing gender equality and women's empowerment. More pledges and donations, please.
Thank you very much to the one that we don't pledge so far. And we hope that there will be encouragement or motivation to other people that were there for kind support. Kindly support. from Women's Forum.
Is there another association of journalists large? Any pledge, any donation? Any donation or pledge? I see the financial secretary this month, Mohamed Konya. Or Whipsaw, Adam Taylor. Any pledge, any donation?
$1,000.
hope and women's empowerment generally. Let's see the hands of these generous people. Very generous people. Very, very, very extremely generous people. Dinner is being served. Dinner is being served. Let's see the hands, please, who are still strongly leading with all of you to be supportive. Yeah, because we don't want to force people to support. But we do say we all now at least able to buy one bag of cement and be women's school for support and construction. Let's see the people who, out of the goodness of their hearts, are deliberate enough to say, I am supporting women's. More donations, more pledges than donations. Who are the very nice people?
We get the foundation, we get up to the roof. So we need from the foundation to the roof. Any form of donation pledge we do. We've had from $1,000 to 100 million. So, one maximum.
You could even support with tools you ever need. Green macro, a pan, pickaxe, there's a whole lot. So while we still acknowledge all of the equal pledges and donations, I'll mind you, the pledges and donations continue even after the event. So even if you get home and you decide to support, you could just contact the women forum and make available the support you want to make to them. But while we still encourage you to pledge and donate towards the construction of this magnificent building that Women's Forum would like to construct on this land, and while you also enjoy your dinner, we would like to get a performance by a very talented lady here tonight.
Sister Cordelia, to give us a musical performance, ladies and gentlemen, big welcome. Well, Sister Cordelia.
Please put your hands together as she comes out. Please clap, clap. At least if you're not donating, donate you clap.
She has been on the musical stage for a while. And she has a remarkable blueprint in the musical, in the music industry, and she has a good real music.
Let me see the hands of all the beautiful ladies in the house. Let me see the hands of all the beautiful ladies in the house. All right, she went up. Music.
anyway.
About 50 individuals, Madame Kapoor,
We are looking to recognize your presence and your ministries. Let me also recognize the presence of the first female Vice Chancellor Square in the academy sector. I listened to one of the contestants of his FBC the other day. She was highlighting that. That's probably what every university was saying. That's how they had a female chancellor or head of that institution. So the first female vice chancellor of IPAM Institute of Public Administration and Management, Professor Claria Morgan Conte. Madam, we recognize you and we honor you. Hi. President of the Olympics Committee also recognize you, sir, for being here. We do so as we go along. While we are eating, some of the awardees are still going for food because some of their tables have been covered. Mr. DJ, drop us some nice pieces of music while we are waiting their settlement on your tables.